My name is Kamatoma, and this will be a brief introduction to how you can handle files and change files, or how you can read, write, and append files using Python. So any programming language such as Java or PHP or any language such as C#, available or make you the chance or provide tools to save data to files, or you can read data from files. So let's get started, and the first one will be an file 01.by, and inside this file, as you can see, we have an regular Python file. Let's get started by hide this panel by making Control B, and first we will open a file which is text file, and I will say that it's called data.txt, and I will open this as a file object. So we define that this text file as a file object, and after opening this file, we will say that this file has some contents, and we will read this file object like this. And after that, you must print this content or contents such as this. And to be honest, this is a way, and we can now go to run this file. So let's get started by change directory, and again change directory to this one, which is Altohami. So let's go back and change directory to, and we will run this file, which is file 01.by, and we will see that there is no file data.txt, or we will see that there is no outcome. So let's get started by making our file data.txt, and after that we will write first name and second so this is final line. I have typed 4 lines. To be honest, you must save all these files and get started by running Python 3, because we have Python 3. So if you have Python 2, you can go and type Python only without 2, and after that we can run this .by, and it says that Python isn't recognized, so type Python 3 because I have Python 3. And make sure if you have an IDE such as Bashar, you can run the file from your IDE. So let's get started, and it says that the read isn't recognized. So let's go back. And it seems that we have the read. Let's go here, and name read isn't defined. All right, so the problem is that we have not like this, but we have the file object. Any object has the read function like this. Let's go back and rerun our file. You must see this is the outcome. So we have the read. We have the content, print the content. So this is one way for running files. Because we have the file here, you can define also the file name here as data.txt, and here replace this data.txt with file name. You must make the name of the file in double string, such as this. Anyway, let's go back and see how we can, if we run, it's the same. And let's see how we can write from file. So let us see how we can writing to a file. To be honest, the first step is file name. We have a new file .txt. With open this file name with the mode of write as file object. And after that, we will say that file object dot write hello there, and maybe copying this one and paste also like this. Make sure that you type it correctly and make sure that you type it the same. And after that, we can run our file. So we will say Python 3 and we have the file 01.by, and it say we have unexpected indent. So we must make all this the same indent, and after that you can rerun our file. So by default, if you have the file in your system, all all the data in your file will be erased, and we will write or replace all the data previously existed with these two lines. If you open this file, you will see one only line, which is hello there, hello world. Let's see how we can. Here we have only one line. To make two lines, you can go and press these backslashes in to make two lines. And we can say file object dot write. This is the third line in the new file written using anyway. And you must make the indent the same, and let's go back and make sure you have all these the same. And we will now go back and run this file Python 3 file 01.by, and we will see in a moment this is the third line. And as you can see, we can now print data is successfully written to your which is file name, and this is function. Anyway, let's go back and run our file again. Let's make sure that you have Python 3 file 01.by and data successfully written to this new file .txt. Alright, this is pretty straightforward method, and we will go to the next lesson, and let's see how we can append data to a file. So we have already new file .txt. Let's see how we can append maybe three more lines or around 10 lines as you like. You can add any or append any new files as you want. So the method is by going to let's go to a new file 02.by, and after that we will say that we have the file name will be the new file .txt, And again, let's with open, we will open this file name and with the method which is append a. Make sure that we have also read and write with this one. If you want to read and write, you can go with this R plus, but we want only append, so we will open this file in the append mode, and we will open this file as file object. And what is useful from using with function? So using the with function, you must sure that the file will be closed once access is finished. So you must sure that the file will be closed once the access is finished to this file. Again, we will make something. We will try to let's see how we can. We can go back and say file object dot append. We have the append function. We will append some line, which is this is new line. And let's go to this new line. I will copy this line one time, and after that let's go back. Make sure that the indent is the same. We will print the message for the user. We will print that the file or the data has been written successfully to which is the file name, and make sure you have typed it file like this. And let's go back. We have this file 02, and we will run file 02.by. So it say that has no attribute append. I think that the append we will go to make it right, and let's make it right and go back. So the data has been written to the new file. You can expect that we have 5 lines now. We have 5 lines exactly as we expect. To continue our lesson, we will talk about something new. We will talk about the try except. So if you have the Python shell here, let's clear all this. Can you print 5 by 0? I think you will see an error. In math, you can't divide 5 by 0 because this is zero division error. How we can handle this exception inside Python? So Python give you the ability to handle all these exception. How you can handle all these exceptions? So basically, if you have an error, you can use the try except block, to handle all these errors. Let's see how we can get this to handle all these errors. So we can use try. You can print 5 division by 0, and if there is any exception, you will print except of we have the exception here, which is 0 division error. So 0 division error, you will print to the user you can't divide by 0 like this. Anyway, let's run our file. We have this file 03 and Python 3 file 03.by, and it say that we have invalid syntax. Where is the invalid syntax? It say that we have invalid syntax in line 1. So let's try again. We have in this one, it's a invalid syntax. I think we must go out from the Python shell, and you can now Python 3 file 03.py, and you can't divide. We are now here in the Python shell. You must go to the directory, and we can't divide by zero because we have the exception. So if you make it any number like this, let's go back and run our file. We have the it to be double like this, and let's see what we have else. We have also an exception which is called, let's try an exception. So bias is something keyword in Python which tell the interpreter or the Python language to maybe going to ignore this line or go to the next line. So let's go back, and we have the file not found error. This is used a lot if you want to find the file. This is advanced topic, and we will cover in the next lesson. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. See you in the next course.